Hi, kiddos. Oh, did you not recognize me? It's me, Mrs. Barnard. Ah, oh, I know what it is. It's because I'm surrounded by a big mess. Look at this place. Can you believe this? I'm sitting in my house in Mr. Barnard's office, and he keeps things a little bit messier than I like. But that's okay, right? It's still me, Mrs. Barnard. I'm just in a different space. I wanted to welcome you to this very special time in our day and our very first day of reading workshop. This is a very fun time where we are going to learn how to read together. I'm in my house, you are in your house, and what I want to tell you about that is that readers can read anywhere. Even if we're surrounded by a little bit of mess, which I can ignore, right? I hope you can too. You might be surrounded by books in your house. I have some of mine right around here. And if you don't have books at home, you have books on your iPads. So whether you're reading at home or maybe in somebody else's house, maybe you're at grandma's or grandpa's today, wherever you are, we are going to learn how to read together. Are you ready? Let's get started. In order to start first, I have got a new song to teach you, and it is called Our Gathering Song. And we'll sing this when it's time for reading workshop. Are you ready to learn it? I'll teach it to you. Our Gathering Song. It's time to read now. It's time to read now. Here we are. Here we are. We're finding what to read now, sitting in our spots now, ready to read, ready to read. Do you want to sing this song with me this time now that you know it? Let's do it. You ready to sing? It's time to read now. It's time to read now. Here we are. Here we are. We're finding what to read now, sitting in our spots now, ready to read, ready to read. Where's your reading spot? It might be at a desk, it might be on your couch, it might be on your floor. Readers can read anywhere. Today, I want to teach you that readers walk through the world in a very special way. They don't just walk around and see things, they walk around and read things. So we are going to give that a try today. We are going to look at some things. And then we are going to think, what might that say? And then we are going to read some things. I found some things in my house that have words on them, and I thought we could give that a try and see if we can read those things. Let me see. What about this word? Do you know what that says? I heard some of you say it already. Cheetos. Did you know you could read that word? Oh my goodness. That's right. These are Cheetos. Did you hear that sound at the end? Cheetos. Yeah, that's an S. S. Cheetos. What about this one? Do you know what that says? You know this one too? Macaroni and cheese. Oh my gosh, you are reading those big words too. All right, I have one more. What about this one? Do you know what that says? You've got it. Ketchup. Oh my gosh. I just went in my house and found a few objects, things that have words on them. You can find a lot of things in your house that you can read already. You could read books, or you could look at your toys. I bet there are toys that have words on them. Board games have lots of words on them, and lots of foods like ketchup or Cheetos or macaroni and cheese. You can read those words too. So, readers, I want you to spend some time today. Maybe if you've got books at home, reading a couple of books, or walking around your house and finding objects that you can read. You can even get on your iPad and read books in Kids A to Z. I want you to remember that we can look, we can think, and we can try really, really hard. If we try really, really hard, we can read. All right, off you go, readers. I can't wait to hear about the things that you spent some time reading today. See you next time.